false memory of a remote weather station. You were isolated from the rest of the world, locked inside your coma. We interacted with you daily, encouraging you to wake. Your family would do number puzzles with you. Anything really to bring you back.
Yeah.
People needed answers.
I haven't done number puzzles in years.
I have
Can you tell?
Signal here for you, James. It's
no!
5610 FM. You can't miss it.
Ow! Damn it! Alright. See, we used to play like Risk and strategy games, and Monopoly, cards.
Oop. Type in the numbers, James. You gotta see this.
What? Can you say time curse?
12.
19, your face is so fat!
2304.
I was good.
Numbers, James. We gotta see this. This is 20F. 12. 19. 86. 23.
Did he say 20F?
Type in the numbers, James. We gotta see this. This is 20F, 12, 19, 86, 23, 04. Type in the numbers.
Yeah, he did.
You gotta see.
Okay, report. Yeah, I'm sorry. We never played Morse code as a family thing, you know. We were normal. So... Wilson Police Department Road Traffic Accident Report File. Okay, that would explain what we saw while we were walking around. Oh, this is gonna get meta as hell. Number of vehicles, 20F fatal accidents. That's what the 20F is. You gotta be shitting me. Oh, God. All right, Pleasant Hill Forest Road. Injured. James. One way we drive. Station wagon. Whites. So got into a car accident. Got put into a coma. Passenger. It's been removed. They were killed in the process. Named Charles Hangings. Hangings? Let's see here. 17-4-1940. I was born in 1963. And then coma, and then we got out of the coma. Sedan blue. So that was both the white wagon and the sedan, or station wagon. So arrived on the scene to discover two cars that had been involved in a head-on collision. Mr. Atten found lying down outside his vehicle with head injuries. An ambulance was immediately called. His passenger was trapped in the vehicle in critical condition from wounds sustained in the collision. The driver of the blue sedan, Mr. Hennings, was found dead on arrival. It was noticed that there was a strong smell of whiskey from the driver and an empty whiskey bottle on the passenger seats. Mr. Ashton was questioned on scene. He described an oncoming blue sedan being clearly out of control, which he swore to avoid. Mr. Ashton's passenger was his sister. The driver of the blue sedan is an ex-police officer of 20 years. Wow. Alright, so what are the numbers that we're trying to locate here? Thinking sister... Actually, it might be an order of circle, right? That makes the most sense. So... Oh shit, you're right, the whole it's all your fault. That would explain episode 1 and the boarded up room. Oh, this game is meta. Alright, whiskey control, but, I wonder, do I gotta put in fatal accident or 20F equals... Let's try 20F equals... Okay. Damn, this game. Empty whiskey? Second word? Just gonna assume that everything is... Okay, and then last one was... Out of control. Jeez, this game is meta! Love it! Damn it, okay, so how about we try... Just fatal accident? No. Code reference report. This is the only report we have. 20F, fatal accident. Oh, let's try this. Okay, let me add the 20F. There we go. Woo! That's actually a really good question. Why is there black dad tax?
You have to face it, James. Finally.
That's my sister talking. What do you want to bet? 7,000 FM?
Not like you, at all. I've worked with Officer Hennings for 6 years, and not once have we even talked about alcohol. Drunk driving.
Can't feel my legs, I'm tired.
He was a
yep.
Father, a husband, he was fine. No way he caused this. It's him. This Haitian guy.
Slams shut, plunging you into darkness. A light flickers on. I can move around again. Oh, this is such a great... I mean, this game is $10. Totally worth it. This doesn't make sense to you. Door opens. You step out into the hospital ward, only it seems abandoned. Your vision is blurry. Due to head trauma and possible lack of, Oh, shit! Pants. Yeah, brown pants. Still recording the tape, by the way. Driving home? Don't have that fifth pint. Wait, why would you have the first four? I don't... Why would you have the first four? That doesn't make any sense. First steps to recover. Okay, one. Apparently, he's farsighted. Holy crap. That's... Oh, that is so cool. I mean, if you're gonna use depth of perception, and the character has a head trauma slash possible no glasses, that is awesome. Oh shit, you tense up, someone else is here. Your dead sister. She's pissed. She has no legs. Hello? So somebody knocked that down. Holy hell. Kind of like when I first saw this pop up on Steam earlier this year, I was like, eh, man, we should have played it when it came out. This game's $10. Yeah. It's only $10. You grab the keys from the table, they weigh heavy in your hand. So I guess this is an indie game, and then Devolver's like, hey, that looks great, we'll publish it. Sounds like Devolver. You only caught a glimpse of the room. You guess that's why. Yo, shit! Take it, you guys. This game is great. It is. God, the only video they have, some horror compilation. Trash! Damn, guys, Ontosaurus. It's totally trash, guys. It's all trash. God, this really reminds me of, like, Tales from the Crypt. We realize, oh, it's from their perspective. No. The waiting area is dark, but you can feel a presence right behind me? No, don't say that. That is like the not thing to say in a game like this. That's the not thing. Locked! I have a key. I'm hoping it automatically uses said key. Otherwise, uh-oh. We're mode. Someone breathes on your neck standing. Stop doing that. It's not cool. You feel dread in the pit of your stomach. Ah, that's really bright. Episode two. Vehicle collision.
He was awake and mobile at the scene, but collapsed on arrival to the emergency ward.
What the shit?
I'm getting no pulse. Prepare for defib. Amp charge full to 10 and give me 100 joules.
Oh. Thanks, Willow.
Come on, 100 joules. Charging up full to 10. Come on.
Okay. Okay, I'm trying to figure out what I gotta do.
Come on, 100 joules. Charging up full to 10.
Ah! Oh, here we go.
Clear. No reaction from first stage.
Oh my god, these are the stages of you dealing with this. You jump. Hey. Yes, man. You and me both, brother. You and me both. I think I'm still in a wheelchair.
Keep the charge at 10. Let's go.
All right, let's get it all the way up. Let's amp it up. Almost there. Charge.
Clear. Okay, we have a reaction of some sort here, a weak signal. Let's keep going. Increase again. 360, charge full. Come on, 360, hurry.
That's just the world we live in.
Clear.
See, if they can't get you with the defib, they're gonna get you with the drill bit.
Seems we have a pulse. Rhythm is stable. We need to run an x-ray right away.
This is so good. Okay.
Where are we with that x-ray? Let's get it going now, please.
Everything you learn, you apply here.
Looks like an intracerebral hemorrhage. We need to drain this now to relieve pressure.
There's the drill.
Switch on a drill, please.
Since he had head trauma, they have to actually relieve the pressure. Oh my god.
The drill, please. Mr. Asian, you've made excellent progress. You're doing great. We need you to stay calm and try to relax.
Could you imagine this in VR, like, seeing that?
Alleviate some of this discomfort.
Okay, I can hear it right here, and that is an... Oh, God. That is a really unsettling sound. God, guys, with the headsets, this game is... it's beautiful. Not only is tonight New Year's Eve, but tomorrow you leave on a 6-month trip aboard with friends. Mom, Dad, and your sister Jennifer have decided to throw a party to celebrate it all. The house is full. You're in the living room and, as usual, losing your damn shit. You don't recognize a soul. Look around. The room is full of chatty strangers, mostly friends of Mom and Dad. There's a door to the hall. Open door. Sorry, I don't understand. Go to door. Kill everyone. look at door. The doorway is wide open, allowing guests to move freely throughout the house. Go to door. Actually, go to doorway. Okay. Go through doorway. Nope. Okay. Look. Go to doorway. No. Okay. Look. Go to hall. You push through the crowd into the hallway. There we go. The hallway is as welcoming as ever. Only this time the folks have put a great big banner up across the main wall. Half-finished drinks are abandoned on almost every horizontal surface. Stairs lead up, although the party is firmly downstairs. Go upstairs. As much as you'd love to, you promised you'd stay downstairs with the party. Oh, if you could actually just take everybody out. Drink? You aren't drinking someone else's drink. Get your own. Go get drink. Sorry? Get drunk. Chug. 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 let's see here. Bashman drinks are abandoned on the stairs lead up, although the party is in. Yeah, could go to kitchen. Go to kitchen. They say all the best parties are in the kitchen. The kitchen is full of people and loud. There are drinks and food on the table, and the party is in full swing. Dad has cooked a hog roast, which sits proudly on the table, but no one is eating it. Eat the roast. Maybe later. Go to drink. I'm sorry. Drink. You pour yourself a drink. Nice to loosen up. Go to living room. Okay, that's not an option. Drinks and food on the table. Eat the food! I don't know what you're trying to use. Okay, Dad has cooked the hot roast. Bradley's on the thing. Look around. There is a utility room and writing on the wall. Also, Jen is here signaling you. Go to Jen. You push through, apologizing over and over to get to Jennifer. Chug, 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 chug. You hug. You're going to miss each other. You thank her for the party. She asks if you are enjoying the party. Sure. You tell her it's great, even though you don't really know anyone. She tells you to enjoy it anyway and to loosen up. She asks you to get her a drink. Get her a drink. You pour Jen a drink, and one for yourself, too. Wait, I just had one. That's two. Okay. There's never an awkward silence with Jennifer. She always has a question. She asks if you have everything sorted for the big trip. Sure. You tell her yes, that you've packed everything with plenty of room to spare. Another hug. Your family have really gone out of their way to make this trip happen for you. It might be what you need to get some perspective and maybe not to up so much. She's going to miss you. You are going to miss her. She walks away. Jen has disappeared into the crowd. You're left standing, nodding, and smiling at the approving faces. There's so much to do for this move. Can't mess it up. But first, a drink. You pour, and down another drink. Anything to move the night along. You pour. Let's see, go to living room. Okay, how about this? Look around. The room is full. There's a utility room and writing on the wall. Read the writing. Read the writing? Okay. Open. Oh, actually, go to utility room. Hang on. Look around. Room is full. Utility. Open? Utility room? You open the door and peer in. You're never allowed in here normally. This is where Dad keeps his fine wines and whiskeys. Ceiling to floor racks. A collector, although he does actually drink them too. There's a bottle with a ribbon around it and a card. Oh, shit. Open card. Open note? look at card. There we go. You pick up the whiskey and the card. It's your dad's handwriting. Son, we're so proud of you and everything you've achieved. You've earned this. It's a bottle of 25-year-old double malt. You shouldn't really, but you have to try it. Drink, 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 drink! With your whiskey in hand, you take in the room around about you. There must be hundreds, no thousands of pounds worth of drink in here. You really must thank your dad for the whiskey. Drink. Oh, damn it. Okay. Leave room. You head back into the kitchen, clutching your new best friend. Yeah! You stumble out of the utility room and back into the kitchen. That is one strong whiskey. You take another swig and give the thumbs up to the dad across the room. He nods and winks. It's the best. calling something? Probably a hit and run. Or just a big old crash. Look at writing. Sorry, I don't know what you're looking at. Okay. Go upstairs. Go into living room. Go to living room. Drink? You pour and... Okay. This guy's getting shit-faced. go to dad. Okay. Look. Leave house? You go back out to the hallway. Alright. A few bumps and laps on the way through, and you make it to the hall. You stop dead in your tracks. It's Jen. Covered in blood. Giggle. Wait, what? What the shit? She's staring straight at you. No one else notices. I am so sorry. That was a dick thing to do. I didn't think it was going to be an option. Look at Jen. Blood is dripping down her face. It's mixing with tears. Giggle. Okay, I'm sorry. I don't understand. Go to Jen. I'm sorry, I don't understand. Giggle. I'm sorry, I don't understand. Leave the house. Lights flickering. I'm sorry. Wait. Don't understand. That's Jen's face. You look so pretty. Oh! Broke the computer.
Sorry, I don't understand.
We tried our best, Mrs. Asian, but her injuries were too severe.
No.
Asian. Okay, Asian. I keep just talking butchering that.
I'm afraid Jennifer passed away before we could get to her in surgery. We did the best we could. I am so sorry.
I can barely move around, by the way.
Please, Mrs. Asian, take a seat.
I don't want to take a seat. Let me talk to her. Now.
I'll arrange for you to see her.
No, you're her brother.
He's stable for now.
I don't want to see him.
You killed your sister, or at least you're responsible for the car accident. You were standing in the hallway. Something has stopped you in your tracks. While searching your mind, your sister interrupts. She waves her hand in front of you and asks if she can, if you can drive her home. You still feel out of sorts. Those words echo. I am drunk. I'm sorry, I don't understand. I am shit-faced. Get dad to do it. take her home. Leave house. You need to tell me which room you want to go to. Go upstairs? You'd love to call it a night, but Jen is waiting patiently. Aww. Drink. Don't know what you're trying to do. Damn it. I a little partially responsible for this. You still fell out of sorts. Go to Jen. Or look around. Doors to the kitchen and living room lead from here while the stairs can take you up. Yes. Tell her no. Tell her yes. Look at Jen. She's waiting patiently for that ride home you had promised her. Yes. No. Okay. I don't know if there's actually multiple endings to this. I know very little about this game. Drive her home? No. No. Get in car? You tried? Ooh. It's all my fault. Damn it! I thought that'd be, like, at least an Easter egg, right? Damn, okay. Sure. Okay. Let's do this. Bros before... let's see. Keys. Car keys. Go to keys. Go to door. You need to tell me which room you want me to go to. Okay. I'm trying to figure out, like, how... Leave house? You need to tell me which room you want to go to. Go to living room. You're sure your keys are in the living room? There we go. Okay. Living room has as much, much more relaxed atmosphere compared to the kitchen. Various guests are sat on the chairs having civilized conversation. There's a coffee table in the middle of the room. Your mom is pouring a drink at the drinks cabin. Go to mom. Okay. Get key. Look around. There we go. Coffee table, drinks cabinet. One of the chairs is overlung with jackets and coats. Go to chairs. Go to cabinet. Drink. Okay. Go to drink cabinet. Oop, there's a bee in there. No, no. Check chairs. Go to keys. Go to... I don't know. Coats? Look around. Oh, that's... Nope, oh, that's about that wrong. Coffee table. Ooh, go to coffee table. Check coat. Grab coat. Go to coat. Die trying? What the hell? Okay, I'm trying to figure out the prompts here. Coffee table, drinks cabinet. One of the chairs is overflowing with jackets. Go to... Jacket? Check? Jacket? Yeah, I tried to grab keys, like, see? Go to... Mom? Look at Mom. She's totally in her element here. She always loved being the host. Okay. Look at... Coats. You search through all the jackets and coats until you find yours. Aha! Car keys in the pocket. You grab both. There we go. Okay. Leave. Keys in hand, you head back into the hall. Jen thanks you for helping her out. She has work in the morning, and no one else is in any state, in fit state to drive. You can handle it, though. You know the road like the back of your hand, don't you? No. Oh, I thought that was... Okay. Go to Jen. Leave house. You open the front door and walk into the freezing night. Go... Oh. The cold air hits you. You are glad you have your jacket with you. There is a dusting of snow around you as you step down from the porch. The yard extends around the back of the house, and the car sits at the front of the house. Gets. Let's see here. Go to car. You fumble with the car handle, confused, until Jen tells you to maybe use the key in your hand. Sis, I am too drunk to open a door. Why are you letting me drive the car? Use key. Fumbling with the car keys, you eventually get the door open and climb inside. The car is freezing. As you fumble around with your seatbelt, your sister opens up the car glove box and hands you a note and a key that was inside. She tells you that it's for you when you return. Read note. The note is from your dad and reads, "Hi son, hope you enjoy your break. You'll need to fire up the generator around back to get power and lights on. Also found something in the attic for you. It's in your room. Enjoy." That's where the tie-in is. The car is freezing. If you can't, yeah. Turn on car. You try to turn the ignition with sheer willpower, despite holding keys in your hand. Leave. Look around. The usual. Steering wheel, handbrake, ignition. Oh my god. Handbrake. I'm sorry, I don't understand. So wait. Do I have to go through the whole process here? What am I doing here? Because use keys doesn't work. See, like, takes a number of attempts, but you eventually slot the key in the ignition. Okay, we got it. Actually, vomit. I'm sorry, I don't understand. Okay, turn on car. You turn the key in the ignition and the car roars to life. Handbrake. Okay, never mind. Leave? Jennifer is getting impatient. If you value your life, you had better get her home now. Okay. Take her home? Go to home. Drive? The car squeals but stays stationary. Jen suggests releasing the brake, giving you a wide-eyed stare. Okay, sis! There is problems right now! You should stop me! Unless this is how I normally drive, in which case... Oh god, why did you give me a car? Okay. Remove and... Thank you! Look at handbrake. Handbrake is what's... Handbrake! Look around! Okay, the usual steering wheel. Handbrake, yes. Ignition. Handbrake. Guys, handbrake. Come on. Alright. Look at handbrake. Release. Let's try this. Release. Handbrake. Yeah, working on it. You very hesitantly release the handbrake. Drive. You put the car in gear and pull out the driveway like a first-time driver. Shit, we're screwed. I am driving very drunk on the road towards the town where your sister stays. Jen stared, sort of dozing off as soon as the journey got going. It shouldn't take long. You come to a junction. Is it left or right? You can't remember. It's left. It's always left. Okay, it's right. It's never right. Okay. Go left. You don't want to, but you had a better ask Jen for direction. Ask Jen. She grunts and throws her arm to the left. It's left. Of course it's left. Ha! Turn left! You turn the car left at the junction and accelerate off. Confident that you are on the right road now, you loosen up and put your foot down on the accelerator. You feel powerful as the engine roars at your command. Jen sits up in her chair and clutches your arm. She asks you to slow down. Slow down. That's not what really happened, though, is it?
You're all over the place, James. Pull over.
Oh, shit. Jen is hitting your arm and yelling at you. Crazy sister. Strange. there's a set of headlights coming directly at you, but really slow. Like, slow motion. Slow down. You try to react, but your body isn't responding. There's nothing you can do to stop this. There's no way to control it. The lights merge with your car. The James, outside joins sick, the inside. Over. The whole world around you begins to scream.
James!
It was at this very moment, wasn't it, James? The moment you lost it all. Your sister. Your parents. Yourself. And then you made it worse. Go on. Show us what you did.
You wake up in the car. Your world is upside down. Your seatbelt struggles against gravity, trying to hold you in your seat. An impact into another car has torn a hole in the chassis. Poisonous fumes spill into your car from the engines. You are in grave danger. You have to get out of here. Look around. The car is broken beyond repair. The windows are smashed, and there is wreckage all around. You are both wearing your seatbelts. Remove Jen's seatbelt. You release yourself from the seat. Gravity takes over as you slump onto the roof of the car. Wait, no, I didn't want to do that. Get Jen out. You can't move the wreckage from around her. It would be too dangerous. Save yourself. Remove the wreckage. I don't know what you're trying to use. Damn it! You squeeze through the wreckage and fall to your knees on the ground next to you. Every breath brings pain in your chest. Your head is throbbing. A blue car has smashed into the passenger side of your car. Your life cannot be ruined by this. You are standing, holding your whiskey and your dad's note, and flashing lights are approaching at a distance. He blamed it on the dead guy. Look around. A crash site. Smoke billows from the crashed cars to the sky above. Serial lights flickering on and off. Go to car. What car? The other blue car or yours? Blue car. I'm sorry. Drink? I'm sorry, I don't. Go to blue car. The door is jammed. You don't have time for messing around like this, James. Break window. Open door. What car? Open blue car door. Read note. The note, always changing, now reads, "Get through this, James. I don't care if you want to or not." Oh my god, when the note was like bleeding and going and billowing and being oily? That's all from the crash. Jeez, this game is amazing. Let's see here. Look at blue car. The hazard lights are blinking and fumes are rising from the engine. Through the smash windows, you can see the motionless driver. Go to driver. Oops. Go to driver. Look at driver. It's an older man. His body is slumped and his face is bloodied. Okay. It won't let me open blue car door. Yeah, it won't let me do it. Okay, so I'm trying to think what I could do here. Give bottle? Give whiskey? Plants? Whiskey? With the lights approaching closer, you begin to hear the shrill of their sirens. You simply cannot go to jail for this. You clean the bottle to remove your connection with the whiskey. You then very deliberately spill the remainder of the bottle's content onto the driver, and you toss the incriminating evidence onto his passenger seat. A circle of flashing lights surround you, illuminating the crash site in the darkness. Behind them, an army of people all staring. One figure steps out, a silhouette, and walks towards you. Look at figure. Silhouette is a police officer, and in uniform, he beckons you to approach. Go to officer. As you approach, the man, the pulsating lights around you get dimmer and dimmer.
I know you're tearing yourself apart over it, but no matter what you keep telling yourself, you have to
listen. I'm not the dick!
A poor man. Me. You have to remember. It was all your fault.
Oh, shit.
I know what you did. How you left me there to protect yourself. Planting evidence on some poor man. You went headfirst into that officer and you wrecked all of our lives. And you couldn't even take responsibility. You did the right thing for you and no one else. Save yourself. Only it was wrong. But you're now utterly consumed by it. Say it, James.
Dr. Alexander is always watching remotely. I don't know if anyone else is ever with him.
Listen to yourself.
All of your episodes were recorded at the tape. This is the fourth. Oh, shit.
Well, I think we've made progress. I guess we should tell the police we've told us. Although I don't suspect they'll take you anywhere. I think you'll be with us for quite some time. Come on, let's get you back to your shows. I'll see you tomorrow.
Achievement unlocked! Admission! Oh my god, that was amazing! Oh, that was so good! Holy hell, that was great!